Hey, what's going on, people? It's SGZ here from the Spartan Game Zone, and in this video I'll be showcasing 5 legendary weapons that just need a buff, and I'll also be showing you where you can get them in case you want one for yourself. With Mayhem 2.0 coming up, there's a few guns lagging behind the rest that would be useful at full strength. Now, these guns aren't necessarily the 5 worst legendaries in the game. Some of them are really bad, but others have effects that deserve to shine, and do let me know what weapons you'd like to see buffed, and I might showcase them in the future. This video will shed some light on 5 legendary weapons, hopefully enough to get them seen and brought up to their full potential by Gearbox. Maybe we could be seeing the next lob. If you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate you if you could drop a like. It helps motivate me to upload more videos, and let's get started. Up first we have the Super Ball, a melee 1 pistol that has an increased chance to drop from Baron Noggin. You fight around in this area of the Meridian Metroplex. The Super Ball is comical at best. It shoots orbs of fire in a short arc that bounce around multiple times, echoing the sounds of Super Mario. Because of its projectile pattern, it's almost impossible to hit crits unless the end of the barrel is literally touching them, or you calculate the bullet drop off correctly. The same goes for hitting flying targets or bosses that are out of reach. When mobbing, you'll often have to rely on luck to hit your target, and I find it best to just spam the trigger as fast as you can, hoping the bullets bounce kindly and whatever you're shooting at doesn't move before they reach them. It is surprisingly good at lighting people on fire, but they may as well be covered in candy floss. It does very little damage in all areas, and it's just bad across the board. There is potential there though. I mean, look at the lob. The Super Ball has a unique firing pattern that could balance any heavy damage applied to it. For all its shortcomings, I strangely enjoyed my time with it. Watching those glowing coins bounce around was like watching the sunset behind a winter's rainbow. Up next, the ASMD, another melee 1 gun, this time a sniper rifle that has an increased chance to drop from max a trillion. You fight here in Voracious Canopy. The ASMD was the one who got left behind, and it's just not fair. So many melee 1 sniper rifles got buffed, but not the ASMD. The Storm got a buff, the Firestorm got a buff, the Krakatoa got a massive buff. The ASMD is the only one left that didn't get any love. Not even a little hug. I mean, the Krakatoa is sitting at over 13,000 damage at level 57 now, whereas the ASMD is barely passing 3,000. The Firestorm and Storm both complement each other nicely, coming in incendiary and shock elements respectively, but the Krakatoa doesn't have a partner, and the ASMD could be the one for it. It always comes in shock, and you can toggle between two firing modes that each support the other. You can toggle between energy bolt and energy orb. To get the most out of the gun, you want to be firing energy orbs and shooting them with the energy bolt. This will cause the orb to explode, dealing shock damage over a wide area. It's a cool effect that really should do a lot more damage. It's fun to fight orbs between groups of enemies and then shoot them, but there's no reward because the damage simply isn't high enough. You also have a small window to shoot the orb to make it explode, and right now the ASMD is not worth anyone's time. Now to the Breeder, a torque pistol that you can get the quickest by defeating the Psycho Billies, who you find at this point of the map in the Amber Mire. Borderlands 3 has a number of good pistols, but very few truly great ones, and I struggle to think what there is outside of the Maggie and Hellshock. The Breeder could be the third. It's a lot different than the other two, and different to a lot of guns in general. It only comes with a sticky mode, and when you stick projectiles, not only will they deal damage, but they'll spawn a number of MIRV grenades that sprout upwards from the impact point and rain down, causing a series of small explosions. These MIRV grenades hammer the ground around your enemy, which should result in a cataclysm of death, but it's all smoke and mirrors. I'm using a double penetrating variant here, which means more explosions, but none of the health drain. It can also come in any element, which is great and means it's not limited to any battle you may find yourself in, but it is limited in its damage. The grenades are the brunt of its damage, and they take a while to come down, meaning your enemy can avoid them if they move just a few feet. Buff the splash damage and radius though, and you'll have another mobbing menace in your hands. The Spinner is another gun that should be buffed, and it has the highest chance to drop from the Go-Go Power Troopers you fight around here in Atlas HQ. The Spinner isn't a terrible gun, it's still bad when you're looking for Mayhem 4 viability, soon to be Mayhem 2.0, but it could be, and probably should be, a lot better. It fires projectiles in a circular pattern, but because it's a melee one gun and comes in two elements, the projectiles it fires won't be of the element selected, but of both of them. You can still toggle between elements, but rather than the selected element being the only element you fire in, it will be the one more prominent. This effect does have some merit, and could be great. Say you want to irradiate your opponents, but they're weak against fire. You can get one with those two elements, allowing you to kill them quickly while they explode in a radiation cloud, infecting all other nearby enemies. Or maybe you're Zane and you want to freeze people, but don't want to put all your eggs into that basket. Then you just need one with the cryo element. It could be a great gun, and it reminds me a lot of the Florentine, a Seraph weapon from Borderlands 2, but sadly, it falls well short. Last up, the Crossroad, a Hyperion SMG that has an increased chance to drop from Katagawa Jr., an annoying fight that you can attempt here in Atlas HQ. The Crossroad is on this list not for what it is now, but for what it once was. The Crossroad used to be one of the top SMGs in the whole game, until it had something taken away from it. Something that it couldn't live without. A pellet. It also got a big nerf to its accuracy, but the loss of the pellet hit it the hardest, and it's having to learn to live each day knowing that it's somewhere, somewhere out there, man. That's got to be tough. Currently, the Crossroad fires 3 pellets in a 6-round burst pattern, contrary to the previous 4, which is a big 25% drop in damage, and it consumes 2 ammo per shot. The pellets are fired in a linear pattern and are really quite widespread thanks to the missing pellet, an additional accuracy nerf. That nerf at the time was probably warranted, but now it has been surpassed by countless legendaries. It's not bad by any means, and maybe this is nostalgia speaking, but the Crossroad just has the hallmarks of a really good gun. It's pretty much the only burst fire SMG outside of some manufactured by Dahl, and the natural Hyperion critical damage boost is a recipe for a great gun. That recipe was perfected in the past until someone came along and tainted it, so here's hoping Grandma wrote it down. So that's all for this video. Let me know of some guns you'd like to see buffed as we move into Mayhem 2.0 and beyond. And maybe we might see a part 2. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, consider dropping a like or subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one.